Hello students, now we have seen the turbojet engine and we will see the turboprop engine in the jet propulsion. In turboprop engine, a conventional aircraft propeller is usually mounted in the front of the engine as shown in figure. You can see this figure, there is a propeller here, this propeller, like fan like thing it is rotating, okay, in the front. You can see in the small aircraft. The propeller used to produce a thrust by changing the movement of fluid around it. This propeller is used to produce the thrust. Actually, this propeller is connected to this turbine, okay, and through the reduction gearbox, thus here the we want less speed and more torque. So the turbine is rotating at high speed. So we are due to the reduction gearbox, we are reducing the speed but increasing the torque of this propeller. The propeller is coupled to the turbine through a reduction gear that converts the high RPM, low torque output to a low RPM and a high torque. Okay, now we will see the turbo prop engine. It is as similar to the turbo jet engine, only for the exception of this propeller and a reduction gearbox. Otherwise, everything remains the same. Here also you have a diffuser, you have a compressor. Diffuser, as I said, the velocity is reduced, pressure is increased. Okay, then it comes to the compressor. In compressor, the pressure of the air is increased and it is sent to the combustion chamber. In the combustion chamber, we supply fuel and the fuel is ignited, so the fuel burns in the presence of air. And the high pressure gases, high temperature gases, are expanded in a nozzle. And after expanding in the nozzle, the exhaust of the nozzle passes through the turbine is passing through a nozzle and is exhausted to the atmosphere. So the same thing, but here you have got a propeller which does the major work. Okay, so you have a diffuser, you have a compressor, you have a combustion chamber, you have a turbine, and you have a nozzle. In the simplest form, a turboprop consists of a diffuser, compressor, combustor, turbine, and a nozzle. The atmospheric air enters the diffuser, which slows down the air speed, gets compressed to a certain value in a compressor. So the diffuser, which was there in the jet engine, turbo jet also, it slows down the air speeds and converts it to pressure. Then the compressor increases the pressure. Okay, the fuel is then added to the compressed air in the combustor, where the fuel air mixture burns, resulting in high temperature. The hot high pressure gas then enters the gas turbine, where partial expansion takes place. Okay, the part of the power generated by the turbine is used to drive the compressor, while the remaining is transmitted through the reduction gearbox to the propeller. At the turbine outlet, the hot gases whose pressure is higher than the atmosphere is expanded fully in a nozzle, due to which the speed of the exhaust gas is increased. The thrust produced by the propeller and the jet produced by the nozzle give forward motion to the aircraft. So here in the turbojet, there was only one thrust produced by the nozzle, but here you have got the thrust produced by the propeller as well as the jet produced by the nozzle. They move the aircraft in the forward direction. 90% of the energy in the hot gases is absorbed by the turbine, and only 10% remains to increase the speed of the exhaust jet. Accordingly, very small portion of the overall thrust is produced by the jet. Most of it comes from the propeller. Okay, the most of the power, 90% of the power, mostly it comes from the propeller and very less from the jet passing through the nozzle. Turboprop engines are advantageous for small and medium sized aircraft at air speeds from 480 to 640 kilometers per hour. They cannot compete with turbojets for large planes or at higher speed. So as discussed, turboprop engines are very advantageous for small engines, small capacity like 50 seater, 100 seater aircraft, and for small air speed like 400 to 600 kilometers. So like 200, 300, 500, 1000 kilometer distance, they fly. Okay, they cannot compete with the turbojets, which are used for very large planes or they run at very high speeds. Okay, so please see the drawing. The same drawing you can draw for the turbo jet also. In the turbo jet engine, they have not shown the diffuser. Here is the diffuser shown. You can show the same drawing. You can remove only this propeller. You remove this propeller. But there also, turbo jet also, you have got the diffuser. You have got the